Hi, everybody, and welcome to this episode of Class Captures. This is your host, Jasper Sr. Today, I'm going to talk to you about soil and how it forms. Soil is a mixture of rock particles and organic matter. It's a little more detailed than you learn when you were a kid. You were probably simply told, just don't eat it, right? Well, the reason you were told not to eat it is because it was made of little pieces of rocks and dead things. All right. Now, it's important to understand when we use this word organic within this context, we're not talking about food that's produced without pesticides. We're talking about anything that's a product of a living being. All right. So a mixture of rock particles and living stuff mixed together on the earth's surface. And most likely it's there and it supports rooted plants like trees, grasses, flowers, and things like that. Now, it's made of dead things that were once living, but it also is formed through processes of living things. So, for example, like a woodchuck or a mole digging through broken rocks and stuff will weather the rocks apart, exposing these rocks to the atmosphere, which increases weathering rates. Plants will grow their roots into rocks and break them apart. I've mentioned previously about sidewalks, right? A sidewalk is a great example of how plants can weather the landscape, right? Breaking a sidewalk into littler pieces, adding those littler pieces into soil, all right? And then also when plants drop their leaves or stems or stalks, this can release acids, which will, through chemical weathering, decompose. And they'll, through chemical weathering, break the rocks apart. All right. So, and then once these living things decompose, they form what's called humus. That's important to pronounce correctly. It's not hummus. Humus. This is the residue of all of the things that were once living that decomposed, and it's this humus combined with the rock particles or sediments that make soil. Now, soils form in distinct layers, and these layers are called horizons, right? The very top layer, represented in X in this diagram, is where the plants grow. This is the richest, most organic layer, the most organic material. You can see there's roots, there's grasses, all the particles are relatively fine. But they all have characteristics of the bedrock's all the way at the bottom. If you remember back to your Minecraft days, this is when you would dig all the way down in Minecraft and you couldn't get any farther down, right? That's bedrock. It's also known as parent rock. Above the bedrock, you have a layer where there's big chunks mixed in with smaller chunks, not a lot of organic material, right? The organic material is only when you get closer to the top. Now, it's important to note that soil takes its characteristics from the bedrock on which it formed, all right? So if you had granite bedrock, the soil would contain quartz, it would contain potassium feldspar, in other words, the ingredients that you would find in granite. Now, climate is the biggest factor in determining the quality and the amount of soil, all right? The more plants are around, the richer the soil is going to be. And the most plants, most biomass in the world is near the tropics, near the equator. All right. And then also 60 degrees north, there's a lot of biomass too, because that's a particularly wet area. Again, promoting lots of plant growth. All right. But climate does have a really drastic and dramatic impact on the quality and quantity of soil. Now, again, soils form in layers. This is a different diagram showing you again at the top. This is where the rich organic material called humus is located. And then when you get farther down, you get less and less organic material. You get bigger chunks. You get closer to the bedrock. Bedrock is impenetrable, meaning you can't get through it. And water also doesn't flow through it either. Now, soils can be transported or moved, all right? And this is through the phenomenon of erosion, all right? Now, erosion is different from weathering. Unfortunately, people use them interchangeably, and that's incorrect. Erosion is the moving of sediments. Weathering is the breaking down of rocks. Agents of erosion can include wind, gravity, moving water, as seen in the picture, or a glacier, which we'll talk about more. And this is a good time to remind you that sediments will become smoother, smaller, and rounder as they travel down a stream. This is also a good time to just mention if you've ever gone to the Hudson River and you've looked at the Hudson River, it looks brown. It's not because it's dirty or polluted. It's because it's carrying sediments, all right? It's carrying the sediments down the river. It's eroding the sediments from upstream. Now, I'm going to conclude with soils in New York State. Now, the soils are relatively new in New York State within the last 10,000 years. That's because we've had a recent glacial event. A large ice sheet came over New York State in this direction right here by the pink arrow about 10,000 years ago, and it scraped all of the soil off. So New York State has relatively thin, relatively poor soil. You can see the effects of this if you try to dig a hole anywhere in Westchester. You don't get too far, all right, because there's big chunks of rock near the surface. Also, if you spend any time traveling through Westchester, you can't help but notice the stone walls that crisscross through the woods. These were built in the 16, 17, and 1800s as people started trying to farm the area and realized that there was big chunks of rocks sitting around in where the fields were. So they moved them out to try to make the fields a little better for farming. Now, it's not to say there is farms in New York and there's very productive soils, but they're not as high quality or as deep as soils out in the Midwest where there's so much more agriculture. Now, if you've ever been to Long Island is mostly unconsolidated sediments, meaning it's not actually rock. And that's because as the glacier went over New York State, it was like a bulldozer and it just pushed the sediments down there. All right. And that's where the glacier ended. And we'll talk much more about glaciers in the future. But the concept is Long Island is what's called a terminal moraine, which is where the glacier stops. And it's the big pile of sediments that was scraped in front of the glacier. And that's just where the glacier happened to have stopped. So this was a little bit about soils, and in concluding with soils in New York State, I hope you learned a little bit more about soil, also why it's important not to eat soil when you're a little kid. And I appreciate you watching this episode of Class Captures, and I hope you'll catch up with me next time. Bye for now.